हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर डूइंग वेल इन योर स्टडी। सो इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल्स, न्यूमेरिकल्स बेस्ड ऑन इक्वेशन ऑफ मोशन। नाउ बिफोर सॉल्विंग द न्यूमेरिकल्स, फर्स्ट यू सी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट्स। सो फर्स्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट पॉइंट इज योर 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. So whenever we are doing the numerical, first of all we have to convert all the units in a SI. SI means international system of unit. If it is in kilometer, then we have to convert that one into meter, and we have to make all the terms in same unit. So 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. Now if you want to convert the meter per second, that is the unit of velocity, into kilometer per hour, then you can just multiply the given velocity, which is in meter per second, by 18 by 5. So by multiplying 18 by 5, we can convert velocity, which is in meter per second, to kilometer per hour. Similarly, if you want to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, then simply multiply the term with 5 by 18. Now some symbols we need to solve the numericals. U is always used for initial velocity, and for if the body is at rest, then we have to take u as a zero. Next, v is considered as a final velocity, a is your acceleration, t is your time, s is your distance, and minus a or negative a is your retardation. And equation of motions also we need to solve the numericals. Number one, v is equal to u plus at, s equal to ut plus half at square, and v square minus u square equal to twice as. Now let's start the numericals. So page number 26, practice problem number 1, part 1. So I'm showing you at part 1, and you try to solve yourself part 2. A bus starts from the rest and picks up a velocity of 90 km per hour in half minute. Calculate the uniform acceleration of the bus in meter per second. So here, first you write down the given quantities. Given. So bus starts from rest. Starts from rest. It means initial velocity is zero. Rest. For rest, we have to consider u is equal to zero. So here u is equal to zero. And picks up a velocity. Picks up a velocity. It means initially it is zero, but after that it picks up, it increases the velocity. It means that velocity is your final velocity. So v is equal to 90 kilometer per hour. Now see here, 90 kilometer per hour, we have to convert this one into meter per second. So step number 3. Use the step number 3. Velocity in kilometer per hour, you want to convert in meter per second. So 90 kilometer per hour, you can write 90 into 5 by 18. 5 by 18 meter per second. Now, if you solve this one, you will get the answer as 25 meter per second. So So this cancellation part you try yourself. So here initial velocity is 0. Final velocity comes as a 25 meter per second. And the time t is equal to half minute. T is equal to half minute. So half minute. Now again this minute you have to convert into second. And we know that 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So here half into 60 seconds, which comes as a 30 seconds. So we got all the terms u, v and t, and we have to find the acceleration. So which equation we have to use? We have to use v equal to u plus at. So or directly you can use the formula of acceleration. A is equal to v minus u by t. Or you can write here, we know that v a equal to v minus u by t. It means this equation we can write in this way also, v minus u by t. This a equal to v minus u by t and v equal to u plus at, both are same. So now put the values. V is your 25, u is your 0 and t is your 30. It comes as a 25 by 30, and if you divide it, the answer will be your 0.83 meter per second square. Meter per second square is the unit of acceleration, or SI unit of acceleration. Now come to the second question. An aeroplane, second question means practice problem number 2, part 2. So part 1 you try yourself. An aeroplane lands on a runway and comes to a standstill in 20 seconds when the braking force acting on its wheel produces a retardation of 5 meter per second square. Find the initial velocity of the aeroplane during touchdown in meter per second and kilometer per hour. Here you have to find the initial velocity in two times, meter per second and in kilometer per hour. So let's start. An aeroplane lands on a runway and comes to standstill in 20 seconds. So here it comes rest. Okay. So here the final velocity is your v is equal to your 0. And t is equal to 20 seconds. V equal to 0 and t is equal to 20 seconds. So here if you write the unit meter per second, then also correct. 0 meter per second or simply 0. Both are correct. So V equal to 0 meter per second and t equal to 20 seconds. And a retardation. Here it is a retardation. Whenever your final velocity is less than initial velocity, it is always negative acceleration. Negative acceleration means retardation. So here retardation is your A is equal to, we can write as a minus 5 meter per second square. Very, very important point. Whenever in a numerical it is given as an acceleration, then you have to put the positive sign with the value. And if it is written as a retardation, on that time you have to use the negative sign, that is minus sign, minus 5 meter per second square. Now again the same formula we have to use. So you can write, using A is equal to V minus U by T. So put the values. A is equal to, what is A here? Minus 5. V is your 0. U you have to find. And T is your 20. So this one will be minus 5 is equal to minus u by 20. Cut the minus minus sign from both sides. Bring this 20 here. So 5 into 20 which is equal to u. So 5 into 20 will be 100 which is equal to u. Therefore, u is equal to 100 meter per second. This is your first part. So first part will be your, first part is your u equal to 100 meter per second. Now this 100 meter per second you have to convert in kilometer per hour. So what we have to use, meter per second you have to convert into kilometer per hour. So for number 2 you can write u equal to 100 meter per second is equal to 100 into, now see here, meter per second converted into kilometer per hour by multiplying 18 divided by 5. So 18 by 5 meter per second. Now if you solve this one 5, then this 2, this is 0. So 20 into 18 you will get here 360 kilometer per hour. So very easy to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour or kilometer per hour into meter per second simply multiplying with these numbers. Now page number 27, practice problem number 3. Again I am discussing here part 2 and part 1 you try yourself. So here a racing car initially at rest means initial velocity is 0. Accelerated at a uniform rate, it means this is your acceleration. A is equal to 5.5 meter per second square for 10 seconds. T equal to 10 seconds. Calculate distance covered and number 2, final velocity in kilometer per hour. So for distance covered, which equation of motion you are going to use? S equal to ut plus half at square. So using S equal to ut plus half at square, u is equal to 0 into 10 plus half, 5.5 into t square will be 10 square. So this is 0 into 10 will be 0 and this one will be 1 by 2 into 5.5 into 10 into 10 will be 100. So this one will be half into, if you multiply this one, it will come as a 550. And divide it, after divide, you will get here 275 meter. So this one is your first part of the question. Now in the second part, you have to find the final velocity. So use this equation. Using v equal to u plus at, u is your 0, a is your 5.5 and t is your 10. So this one will be your 5.5 into 10 which is equal to 5.5 meter per second. But we need answer in kilometer per hour, so convert it. This one will be 55 into 18 by 5. Now cancel it, 505 and it will become 11. And 11 into 18 will be your 198 kilometer per hour. So in this way we have to use the equation of motion to solve the numericals. Thank you.